Let the stitching begin. July 4th at Fort McHenry, the Maryland Historical Society embarked on an ambitious mission to recreate the Star-Spangled Banner flag, the flag that inspired Francis Scott Key during the War of 1812.
You can see the original in Washington, D.C. at the Smithsonian Museum. That flag was made here in Baltimore 200 years ago. So as a celebration of the bicentennial of the War of 1812, this is a project that had to happen.
And it's a big project. The flag will measure 30 by 42 feet. Stitching volunteers will work on it every day over 6 to 7 weeks at the Historical Society in Mount Vernon. They're proud to become a part of history.
To me, this is more. This is making something that's really important to the city, something that is a symbol of the city, and it truly is stitching history.
This is going to be history, and I just thought it was such a unique opportunity. I just had to jump at it.
They're sewing the flag just the way Mary Pickersgill did back in the 1800s, which means no sewing machines. It's all done by hand. And because the fabric is authentic, too, it's loosely woven. These ladies had to learn how to do a different type of stitch.
Because it was all by hand, it had to be sewn in such a way that it held together. So while we would do a running stitch just straight, they explained to us how to do it a little sideways so that it was stronger.
The flag should be finished by the end of August in time to fly over Fort McHenry during this year's Defenders Day on September 14th. And everyone can take part in this piece of history. They're holding a couple of public sewing days.
If you sign up for one of our public days, August 3rd or August 11th, you can come and put your own stitch in this flag. So it's going to be a great project. It's going to, you know, hopefully bring everybody together just like the Defense of Baltimore did.
If you'd like to sign up for the public sewing days and add a stitch yourself, you can find a link on our website, WBALTV.com. In Mount Vernon, Kim Dacey, WBAL TV 11 News.